Thanks for joining us. This is the Signature TV News Updates. I am Brenda Etta. In the headlines, stakeholders of rural areas of Enugu State say corruption remains the greatest obstacle to Nigeria's development. Buhari promises to complete second Niger Bridge and Lagos-Ibadan Expressway before 2023. Brent crude hits $84.5 per barrel. And now, the details. Stakeholders of rural areas of Enugu State say corruption remains the greatest obstacle to Nigeria's development and, if not confronted by all Nigerians, will destroy the country. The stakeholders stated this at a one-day Corruption Tory town hall meeting on corruption held in the state on Wednesday. The Corruption Tory town hall, which was organized by Signature TV with the support from MacArthur Foundation, had in attendance traditional rulers, town union leaders, market women, farmers, artisans, cattle sellers, road transport workers, and other rural dwellers.
Thank the crew for this wonderful visit. Ebedike is always doing things that nobody ever imagined. How he usually come up with some of these programs, I don't know. One of the things that kill a nation, or any, even to the family, we're not talking about communities now, we are talking about the families, is corruption. Corruption is even in the family. But I'm encouraging you. The good work you are doing will always secure you. God will always use it to protect you. You are doing well for the masses.
What this program, they do all the time. Now to point out where corruption, where people, they do bad things. I need make and them madamalo. Ne quote to government is your fight corruption. Oh, na government had a fight. And yashinda no na fight hokwa corruption. Anye worum camera. Anye jesete. Ugonde jimake chuanoro. Maka corruption tori aineme. Corruption. Corruption.
The President, Muhammadu Buhari, has said the 11.9 km second Niger Bridge and the 120 km Lagos-Ibadan Expressway would be completed before his regime ends in 2023. The President gave the assurance at the opening of a two-day midterm ministerial performance review retreat organized to assess progress made towards the achievement of the 9 key priorities of his regime. Buhari also assured that other key projects under the Presidential Infrastructure Development Fund would be completed in the same period. At the event, Buhari highlighted some of the notable achievements of the federal government in the last 2 years, mostly in areas of infrastructure, transportation, economy, electricity supply, the petroleum industry, amongst others. According to him, other two projects that will be completed within the period were the 375 km Abuja-Kaduna-Zaria-Kano Expressway and the East-West Road. The Abe State Governor, Dr. Okezie Igbeazu, has backed agitation to zone the People's Democratic Party PDP presidential ticket in 2023 to the southeast. Last week, PDP stakeholders at a National Executive Council meeting in Abuja zoned the party's national chairmanship position to the north. In a statement and reactions to agitations that the southeast should be allowed to produce the party's 2023 presidential candidate, the governor told journalists on Sunday that it was right and proper for his party to zone the presidency to the south after President Buhari would have completed his 2 terms of 8 years in the spirit of equity and justice. He, however, reiterated that it will be left to the 3 southern zones to go to the negotiation table to microzone it to the particular region that it had never produced presidents. The governor also said the current face-off between the leaders of the indigenous people of Biafra, Nnamdi Kanu, and the federal government could be resolved on the negotiation table to pave way for peace and justice. The Minister of Information and Culture, Alhaji Lai Mohammed, has expressed optimism that Nigeria will emerge from its challenges even stronger. Speaking at a forum organized by the News Agency of Nigeria in Abuja on Sunday, the minister charged every Nigerian to take ownership of the country and ensure it is not plunged into war. He said Nigerians should resist the temptation by some selfish elites campaigning that Nigeria was better divided. The minister described allegations that the federal government is pampering bandits and being hard on self-determination groups such as the proscribed indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, as a misconception and fake news rolled into one. He further said that government was winning the war against insurgency in the northeast, adding that the military has heightened assaults and attacks against insurgents, which has enabled it to reclaim more territories. And in the world of business, Brent crude on Monday hit $84.5 per barrel, according to the Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation, NNPC. Its data indicated that the black gold gained $2.11 per barrel. This was a 2.56% rise. The surge followed a rise in demand for energy that resulted from rebound activities in the face of the refusal of Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, OPEC, to increase supply. The data show that oil prices rose more than 2% on Monday, extending gains as an energy crisis gripping major economies shows no sign of easing amid a pickup in economic activity and restrained supplies from major producers. Brent crude was up by $1.7, a 2.1% increase, closing at $84.09 per barrel, which was the highest price since 2018. And moving to the foreign scene, the African Union says it will extend and expand its military operations against Al-Qaeda-linked Islamists in Somalia to include other member states as its current mandate nears an end on December 31st. According to African Union mission in Somalia, AMISOM, on Sunday, the AU's Peace and Security Council has agreed to shift to a joint mission with the UN that would enable other willing and interested AU member states to join operations against the Islamists. The plan will need to be endorsed by the UN Security Council and the government in Mogadishu. The AU expressed grave concern at the worsening security situation in Somalia, where there had been a worrying resurgence of Al-Shabaab activities. Sunday's AU statement asked the UN Security Council to consider a technical rollover of the AMISOM mandate while discussions continue on the details and modalities for transition towards the post-2021 arrangements. The statement also urged President Mohamed Abdullahi Mohamed, widely known as Farmaajo, and Prime Minister Mohamed Hussein Roble to resolve their differences and refocus on concluding the overdue elections without further delay. In entertainment, American actor Granville Adams, popularly known as the lead character Zahir Arif in the prison series OZ, has died at the age of 58 after battling cancer. In a statement by his family via his Instagram page, the actor died with his wife Christina by his side. Though the family statement was posted on Monday, some colleagues of the late actor had sent tribute since Sunday, announcing the actor's demise. The producer of the OZ series, Tom Fontana, took to his Instagram page on Sunday to share a picture of Adam with the caption, "Good night, sweet prince, and flight of angels sing thee to thy rest." Before his demise, the actor first announced his cancer battle in December 2020 via an Instagram post, where he shared a picture of himself in the hospital. In the world of sports, the Super Eagles avenged their shocking 1-0 loss to Central African Republic in the 2022 World Cup qualifying game at the Teslim Balogun Stadium in Lagos by claiming a 2-0 victory in the reverse fixture in Douala, Cameroon on Sunday. Carl Namgander silenced Lagos fans on Thursday, finding the back of the net in the first minute of injury time after a mistake of Leon Balogun to hand Nigeria their first home defeat in a World Cup qualifying game in 40 years. Balogun, however, turned from villain to hero, scoring the Eagles' first goal on Sunday, which was played at Japoma Stadium in Douala. The Glasgow Rangers defender found the back of the net just before the hour mark, latching onto a long pass to give the Eagles the lead after a cagey start to the game. The Eagles' continuous domination after their first goal paid off in the first half regulation time as Napoli striker Victor Osimhen doubled the lead from close range, connecting with William Trost Ekong's cross. The goal was Osimhen's 8th for Nigeria in 16 international appearances. Before we end the news, a recap of our major stories. Stakeholders of rural areas of Enugu State says corruption remains the greatest obstacle to Nigeria's developments. President Muhammadu Buhari promises to complete second Niger Bridge and Lagos-Ibadan Expressway before 2023. Brent crude hits $84.5 per barrel. Safety and security begin with you. Be patriotic. Report any suspicious activity to law enforcement agencies. Please stay safe. That's the Signature TV News updates on behalf of my producer, Obi Chibueze. Thanks for watching. I am Brenda Etta.